Hi, welcome back to Big Meat Burgers, a restaurant created by me, where we put the eat in meat. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make our classic burger. Now, we've got the grill all fired up and ready, so let's prepare the meat. So what you first want to do is take your meat and get it into four pieces, because we're making four burgers today. So we just gotta divide it into good even sections. And then next, you're gonna wanna form it into balls. Alright, now that they're in balls, you're just gonna flatten it out into patty shapes. So it shouldn't be too thin, but also it shouldn't be too thick. So now that the patties are made, we can add a little bit of seasoning to it before we add it to the grill. But I need to go wash my hands, so I'll be back in a second.
After these messages, we'll be right back.
Alright, so now that my hands are clean, we can add a little bit of the seasoning to it. That was a whole lot. So then we can flip them over and then add seasoning to the other sides. So let me get a spatula. Right. Oh, that didn't work too well. So now we can put them on the grill. Alright, so they're all on the grill now, and so now we just wait a few minutes and then flip them over. Now, people always ask me, why is my meat so good? Now, I always say that I just know the chemistry behind it and how to make the perfect burger. So, there's a special process that goes on called the Maillard action effect reaction. It's a reaction between a sugar and an amino acid with heat, specifically over about 300 degrees or so. And right now our grill is on right about 500, so I think we just made it. So basically what happens is the reactive carbonyl group of the sugar interacts with the nucleophilic amino group of the amino acid, and interesting but poorly characterized odor and flavor molecules result, which is why burgers, especially my burgers, tastes so good and smell amazing. So anyway, now it should be about time to flip our patties. Oh yeah, so that is looking extra thick today.
Oh yeah.
One thing I like to do while the meat is cooking is prep the bun. So this morning I actually went and planted some bun trees, and I think they have grown now, so let me go get those.
After these messages.
Alright, so it turns out the bun tree did pretty well this year and gave me some fresh buns. So now what we can do is put the cheese on the bun, so we know exactly what cheese to put on the burgers when the burgers are ready for cheese. So I probably shouldn't have gotten a bigger plate, but you know what they say, when life gives you small plates. So we can put, so I know three people want white American cheese, and one person wants cheddar.
So I take them.
Alright, so there we go. Now that the cheese is laid out, you're going to want to check on your burgers again to make sure they're not burnt. Alright, well, it looks like the burgers are definitely getting browner. And this is a great example of the maillard effect, because when we put them on here, they were red, and now they're brown, almost a little bit too brown. So let's flip these over one last time. And oh yeah, that is a good looking burnt burger. I think they're pretty much ready to put cheese on. So we only wait a few seconds. Alright, so now it's time to get them on. And remember to stop by your local Big Meat Burgers. This is a map of every Big Meat Burgers on the entire North America. So you probably have one near you. And if not, well, we have hot dogs, we have hamburgers, heck, we have it all. Alright, so there you go. You've learned how to make Big Meat Burgers. Now, you can do this at home, but be safe. Make sure to always wear gloves like I do.